Are you one of those people who have heard of or read their articles ranking four of the top cities in America being in Colorado? Well, in this video, I'm going to tell you things they didn't tell you to consider before moving to Denver or anywhere in Colorado. Subscribe to our channel, and when you do, don't forget to hit the little bell to get notified of our videos covering all things Colorado. I've been receiving questions from lots of people of how it is to live in Colorado. Yes, Colorado has four of the best five cities per a recent article in October 2020, Boulder and Denver being the top two. However, there are things that they didn't tell you. Let's go ahead and cover some of those. We will start out talking about the elevation. The lowest point is 5,130 feet above sea level, which makes the air a lot thinner here and will take a few days or even months for your body to adjust. Altitude sickness is no joke. Drink lots of water while here. Alcohol, that takes a lot more effect on your body. Whether you think that's a good thing or a bad thing, I will leave that up to you. Another thing they don't tell you is about the unpredictable weather. You could have four seasons in one day. So you have to prepare for everything. We can even have winters that last into April, and some winters can get bad, even though recently it hasn't been bad, and the sun usually melts away within a couple of days. However, for the skiers and snowboarders out there, that means they have until sometimes July 4th to take advantage of the world-class resorts. However, they don't tell you how the highway can be hectic at times due to weather and accidents. We're also getting the smoke from the fires from Colorado and even the ones that are in California. And they can get really bad at times where you actually see the ashes falling on you. Now we go on to talking about hailstorms that occur every year, and it will hit at least one city in the Denver metro area hard, usually between the months of May and July. And that hits your ductable, your car, your roof, going on and on. Anyway, next topic is north versus south facing homes. North facing homes don't get as much sun to melt away the snow from your front porch. However, that means your backyard is facing the south and your dogs are able to run around the grass. Then that could be considered a good thing. So this topic actually brings me to my next topic. Colorado residents love their dogs, including myself, little Chiquita. However, if you don't leash your dog, since it's a law, or pick up your dog's waste from a neighbor's yard, they will sure let you know. Colorado has so many dog-friendly breweries as well, so if you're allergic to dogs, then keep that in mind. To all my cat lovers out there, we have love for you too. So another thing they don't tell you, Denver is isolated to where you just can't drive to places nearby like you can maybe do that on the East Coast. If you like the ocean, then Denver is not a place you want to be. However, Denver International Airport is an efficient running airport and has great deals on flights everywhere. Also, if you don't like the outdoors and being out and about is not your thing, then you probably won't enjoy it as much as other people. Lots of biking, hiking trails, climbing, and groups of people who just get together to enjoy the outdoors, whether it's fall or spring. The weather really doesn't stop them. There is so much more we could cover. And if there are any other questions you want us to answer before you move to Denver metro area or Colorado, feel free to reach out to me. I know the Denver metro area well and love making connections with people to go over their options before making that huge move to one of the best cities in the country. See you on the video, and don't forget to subscribe and click that little bell for future notifications. See you soon.